Monday night, your leader said that she was willing to walk away from the EU negotiations if there was a bad deal with no deal. Exactly what would a no deal entail?
So it is a massively important time in our history right now, and that is why I say that the person who's going to lead that negotiation is a critical decision to make for everyone at this election, because it's the person who's going to sit with those 27 other European leaders to negotiate a deal. Now, can I look into the future and tell you exactly what that deal will be like? Or can I look into the future right now and tell you exactly what that negotiation will be and what that deal will be? No, I can't. But like any negotiation, the Prime Minister is standing very strong and stable to be able to give. Britain in that negotiation in a way that actually we would want her to, and has the experience to actually do it. Like any negotiation, they go into it with a very clear view of what they want. All parties do that in this negotiation. Here we've got Britain and 27 other countries, and they will negotiate as part of that. Will we have to be strong and firm and tough and determined? Absolutely. Do we have a plan to do that? Yes.
Once all the three candidates have spoken, obviously it's a hot topic, there will be a chance for you to make a comment back again to see what you're saying.
Right,
please. She will do a deal that's best for Britain.
I'm going to read a quote. If we fail to get a deal, the consequences for Britain and for the economic security of ordinary working people will be dire. Written by Theresa May over a year ago. She said that Brexit would risk the UK going backwards when it comes to international trade. She questioned whether we'd be able to negotiate a new free trade agreement with the EU and on what terms, and pointed out that 44% of our exports is more important to us than 8% of the EU's exports, to us. It's clear, it's my letter, a no-deal scenario will hurt jobs, it will hurt our economy and the livelihoods of hard-working British families. It's got to be stopped, and yet Theresa May is prepared to consider this eventuality. Now, I've been talking to businesses, just two examples, Discovery Channel, which is big, they're really, really concerned about what they do in Europe. They broadcast a whole stack of programmes alongside European national channels, and a small company called Fashionizer in Chiswick that makes uniforms for the hospitality trade. Massive implications just for two particular companies, and many of you, either maybe EU nationals, you may work in sectors which are affected, you may have your salary directly funded by the EU. It's not surprising that this constituency voted to remain in the EU, and therefore that's why I voted against triggering Article 50.
Yeah, I think a year ago today, just before the referendum, every main political party in this country, bar UKIP, made it plain what the outcome of an exit from the European Union would entail. So did every major institution in the country, whether that be the Treasury, the CBI, the vice chancellors for all of our major universities, virtually every serious economic think tank in the country, all put in plain terms what a disaster leaving the EU would be without access to the single market and the customs union. So I don't think there's any question of what that entails if we walk away with no deal, as it's being proposed. it is going to set us back dramatically as a country. It's going to affect every industry. It's going to hit London particularly hard, financial services, but not only London. It'll hit the tourist industry in London and across the area. It'll hit agriculture. It'll hit hospitality. Every sector, every major sector of this country. Our ability to staff public services, particularly those services, social care, NHS, our education services and so on, are reliant on freedom of movement. So the idea of a no deal would be a complete disaster, and even to entertain is wrong. The Lib Dems policy is straightforward. I mean, from our position is that we have to have access to the single market, and we have to have access to, we have to have a deal with the customs union. The terms of the deal, or initial negotiation that the EU has proposed, essentially is that three things have to be settled immediately. The cost of the exit, the Irish border, and the status of EU nationals, something that should have been settled before Article 50 was even triggered. Almost every Labour MP walked through that lobby with the Conservatives, exception of a small handful in Remain communities. Okay. The Labour Party voted en bloc with the Conservative Party to trigger Article 50 without securing the security of EU citizens in this country, something they did not have to do. And we're asking for a second referendum for the people that made the choice in the first place, when we know what the deal is.
I did ask a very specific question. You didn't give me an answer, Mary. Can I therefore assume that the Conservative Party therefore has no idea what no deal means? Yeah. And how weak is that going into negotiations, sitting opposite people who know that and say, well, this is all you're going to get. If you don't like it, you can go away and ruin your country.
Thank you. I'll take two.